Dear students, today we are going to start a very important topic, that is the amino acids. Dear students, amino acids are the bifunctional compounds, means they have two functional groups, which is quite clear from their name that they have one amino group and second acidic group, which is the carboxyl group. So, amino acids can be defined as the small bifunctional molecules that consist of a basic amino group and an acidic carboxyl group. My dear students, amino acids are the monomers or building blocks of proteins. When large number of the amino acid they join together, then a macromolecule is produced, which is called as the protein. So monomers of the protein are the amino acids. My dear students, 170 amino acids have been discovered so far. This number 170 includes both natural as well as the synthetic amino acids. Out of these 170 amino acids, 25 amino acids are found to be involved in the protein synthesis. But keep in mind that most of the proteins, they are made up of the 20 amino acids. Now these 20 naturally occurring amino acids that are the part of the most of the proteins, they are called as the stranded amino acids. And in the books, usually when we study the topic amino acids, our main focus is on these 20 naturally occurring standard amino acids. Now, my dear students, these 20 naturally occurring amino acids all are alpha amino acids. What is meant by the alpha amino acid? Alpha amino acid are those amino acids in which the basic amino group and acidic carboxyl group both are connected or bonded with same carbon. And that carbon to which both these groups are bonded, it is called as the alpha carbon. So all these 20 amino acids are the alpha amino acids. Now let us look into the general structure of these amino acid molecules. In an amino acid molecule, this one is the general structure of the amino acid molecule, in which this carbon is the alpha carbon to which both basic amino and acidic carboxyl group they are attached. My dear students, amino acids differ from each other on the basis of this R group. When this R group is changed, then the nature of the amino acid or the structure of the amino acid is also changed. While this portion of CH, NH2, C double H, it is retained in almost all the amino acids. So amino acids differ with respect to this R group. For example, if we attach hydrogen at the place of this R group, then this one is the simplest amino acid which is sweet in taste. एंड दिस अमीनो एसिड इज कॉल्ड एज द ग्लाइसिन. द वर्ड ग्लिस मीन्स स्वीट. सो दिस इज द सिंपलेस्ट अमीनो एसिड विच इज स्वीट इन टेस्ट. माई डियर स्टूडेंट्स, ग्लाइसिन इज द ओनली अमीनो एसिड इन विच अल्फा कार्बन हैज टू हाइड्रोजन एटम्स. दैट इज द डिस्टिंक्टिव फीचर ऑफ द ग्लाइसिन. इट इज द ओनली अमीनो एसिड इन विच देर इज नो काइरल कार्बन. एंड बिकॉज देर इज नो काइरल कार्बन प्रेजेंट इन इट, सो इट इज द ओनली अमीनो एसिड विच इज ऑप्टिकली इनएक्टिव. While all other amino acids, they are optically active. They are dextrorotatory or they are levorotatory. But it is again very important to note down that most of the amino acids, they are the levorotatory amino acids. Now, my dear students, this one is an example of the amino acid. Now, if we replace this H group with the methyl group, mean on the place of this R, methyl group is attached. This is an other amino acid which is called as the alanine. So when we change this R group, the nature of the amino acid is also changed. Glycine is the only amino acid which is optically inactive, while all other amino acids, they are optically active. For example, in case of the alanine, there are two forms of the alanine that exist. The form in which amino group is attached to the right side, this is called as D form or D alanine or dextrorotatory alanine, and the alanine in which amino group is present on the left hand side, that is called as the L alanine or levorotatory alanine. So these are two optical isomers of the alanine, D alanine and L alanine. In the same way, when we change, keep on changing this R group, then 20 different amino acids are produced, and these amino acids are very important because they are the building blocks of the proteins.